World champions, Olympic gold, bronze, and silver medalists from the four corners of the world are ready to fly today on CBS in the Northwestern Mutual Life World Team Championship. Sports proudly presents part one of the Northwestern Mutual Life World Team Championship from the Bradley Center in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. This is the fourth year for this event, and Team USA with Christy Yamaguchi has come in second every year. But they've beaten Canada and Captain Kurt Browning every time. He's looking for a better finish. And so is Russia, which won the first year when Katya Gordieva skated pairs with Sergei Grinkov. So here are the challengers in this unique event. Team USA, with pair of Rocky Marble and Kala Urbanski, and the Olympic medalists Yamaguchi and Paul Wiley. Team Europe, which has won the last 2 years, featuring the world champion pair of Renee Novotny and Radka Kovashikova, two-time gold medalist Katarina Witt, and Olympic bronze medalist Joseph Sabatchin. Team Canada, with two-time Olympic medalists Lloyd Eisler and Isabelle Brasseur, three-time Canadian ladies champion José Chouinard, and four-time world champion Kurt Browning. And Team Russia, the pair this year, the Olympic silver medalists Denis Petrov and Elena Bechki, Katya Gordieva and former world champion Alexander Fadeev. Everyone skates two programs. Today we'll see the ladies in pairs technical. Everyone skates two programs. Today we'll see the ladies in pairs technical programs. And by draw, Bechki and Petrov of Team Russia were first on the ice. I'm Vern Lundquist, along with our own Olympic medal team of Scott Hamilton and Tracy Wilson. And this is the first of 3 weeks of coverage of this World Team Championship.
Musculature. Look at this move right here. Do a throw triple sow cow. Beautiful 1 foot landing.
Yelena has been suffering from a groin injury, and she said it's so painful even just to walk around, and it just shows how competitive and how trained they are to do an element like that, throw triple sow cow.
Silver medal in France in 92. Dennis and Elena moved to the United States. They've lived here for the last couple of years and recently relocated. They're now living and coaching some in the Richmond, Virginia area.
struggle with nerves. She gets scared to death for every competition, but with experience and a very successful professional career, they're more relaxed on the ice, more now than ever, and their performance level has just increased every year. They're probably the most successful pair team on the professional circuit right now. They're really tough to beat.
And Denis Petrov scored 98.4 out of a possible 100 points for Team Russia, which will send Katya Gordieva to the ice later today. She's backstage right now with two of her competitors and our Andrea Joyce.
Well, this is truly a golden moment. Three Olympic gold medalists. You guys have all been competing for a while now. Christy, is it as much fun as it used to be?
It's still very fun, especially at this competition. We're all going as our own team, the U.S., the Europe, and Russia. So we're having fun, and it should be a good night.
Katya, not the same kind of pressure of the Olympics or the World Championships, but is there a different kind of pressure wanting to do well for your team?
No, we definitely want to all do good for our team, and I don't think I have a lot of pressure, just from myself maybe, and I'm just so happy to have support from Russian team.
Well, speaking of pressure, though, this is your chance, Katarina, to give us some inside information. You guys in the hallways bumping into each other. Who's the most nervous out of all of you?
Me.
You think?
I don't know. I think we're all on the same level. You know, you can see everybody running around being fiddling and just trying to skate well tonight because the season is starting and lots of things coming up. And you don't want to let your team down. So we're all just going to go forward and try our best.
Well, the most important thing is that you're all composed on the ice, and we wish you the best of luck in the competition.
Thanks. For Team Europe, the pair of Radka Kovazhikova and Renee Novotny. And in the spirit of team unity, this couple from the Czech Republic skating to music with an Irish theme.
Side-by-side double flips. That features Bechki and Petrov, you need all the technical ability in the world, and this triple toe loop really hurts. Now look at the triple toe loop. You can see on the way down, she just can't grip the ice, and it goes right out from under her, and those do hurt. One, two, three, and the pick just can't hang on to it. It goes right down. Ouch.
Even with the nasty fall, they kept up the spirit of the program. Great overhead lift. But they did, however, have one other major error, and it came in this spin. Watch Radka almost falling out of the spin.
The mistakes lead to a score of 96-7 for Team Europe, 1.7 behind Team Russia, with Team USA another 0.3 back in third position of the competition from Canada, Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler.
Mm-hmm.
Isabel and Lloyd have always been known more for their tricks, their elements, and they've really paid a lot of attention in the last couple of years to really develop programs that had a lot more footwork in them, a lot more content between the elements, and it's a big improvement.
And Scott, they really have a knack of being able to pick the right kind of music for themselves and for the audience. Their music is usually upbeat, lighthearted, and it's always a hit with the crowd.
This is called Please Clarify.
Throw triple Sal Cow. Big, nice, a little touchdown on the foot. I don't think she needed to do that. Straight, beautiful air position. This next element they do as well as anyone in the world, eligible or professional, triple twist. Look at the height. So much room on the way down. It looks like they could do another two rotations.
Mentioned their innovative tricks. Here's a move they created coming up, the fly high and say bye.
This is a long time to be putting out that kind of energy. They've got to be tired. All in all, a very solid performance.
Lloyd Eisner and Isabel Brasseur, Mrs. Rocky Marble. A strong performance in this technical program. 98 out of 100. 0.4 behind Russia. What was the difference, Scott?
Well, sometimes it just comes down to a foot. Now watch Vetchky Petrov, Brasseur and Eisner. They both get in the air very nicely, both straight in the air. Elena comes down 1 foot. Now watch Isabel's left foot. Watch what happens on the landing right there. She puts it down. The judges notice those things and can cost you 0.1 point.
The standings after the first performance by all four pairs, Russia in the lead, Canada close second, with Europe and Team USA having a lot of ground to make up as we head into the ladies' competition. She married pair skater Jean-Michel Bombardier this summer. And José will skate to the music of Shania Twain. It's called Any Man of Mine.
José has always had trouble with consistency on her jumps. So this year she enlisted the help of Doug Lee, who coaches Elvis Stoiko, and he's really been breaking down the jumps to study the technique. And one of her goals is to get back her triple axel. She says she's landed it 5 times and hopes to have it back this year.
I saw her land a beauty in Winnipeg, Canada one time. It was like single. It was so perfect. So she can get it. Triple toe. Huge! Almost over rotation. Beautiful.
And a very helpful performance for Team Canada. Rock solid for José.
Not only technically strong, but the artistry, the choreography, extremely difficult. The judges are, they have to reflect that. They have to reflect that in the marks for sure.
The jump that José and coach Doug Lee really started working on first was the double axel. Here's a look at José. She said they broke it down bit by bit so she could really understand the technique. Coming up, her second double axel. And as you can see, she has lots of room to add another rotation.
It's always real nice to get support from your teammates. Look how confident Team Canada is. Oh. And it's nice confidence when you got this monster triple toe loop. Now, she gets so much height that she's actually done rotating before she hits the ice with her right foot. She's like, okay, I'm done now. I need the ice. I need the ice. Whoa, hang on. Nice save, José.
You know. It's actually easier for me to do double, but yeah. It's so small, the ice.
Now, the technical mark. And the marks for technical merit. 9-8, 9-8, 9-7, 9-7, 9-8, and 2-9-7. We're out behind the low. 48-7, the total.
Yes.
And the artistic mark. Just a little disappointed now. 9-9.
That's why there's 7 judges. You're gonna have a difference of opinion, but. What matters is how they all feel as a unit.
Good job. That's okay.
So the total for José Chouinard, 97.4. And next on the ice, representing team, is Katya Gordieva with a very special number.
This program was created by Katya and her choreographer, Marina Zueva. Instead of sending flowers or a get well card, this was their way of wishing Scott well. It's called Smile by Unanimous Glue.
Double axel, Came off the heel on the takeoff a little bit, couldn't save it in the air. They always say the toughest jump in skating is the one after the fall, and this is the next one, and it's the hardest one in the program, a triple toe loop. She has to be fully committed. A little tentative in the air, came out a little early.
She makes it look effortless.
It's the jumps. Sometimes she backs off the jumps a little bit, and if she loses concentration for a second, that's where you make the mistakes. Tough night on the jumps, but a beautiful program. She's not going to be happy with the effort. Again, on any given night. And I just started this program on Wednesday. And it was a 50.
Katya Gordieva, representing Team Russia.
Double axel, watch her upper body. It pre-rotates a little bit, and then she leans back. Now it tilts a jump in the air, and there's no way you can snap the rotation very well once you do that. Triple toe loop. Again, she came out a little bit early. It's right. It all looked good through here. She vaulted nicely. She was straight in the air, but she came out right there. She goes, nope, I'm not going to make it, and she came out. Again, you have to be completely, completely committed to do these jumps. And one mistake in the double axle made her a little bit cautious on the triple toe loop.
And at the end of the program, she looks around for Scott and then says, I'm sorry.
Now the technical marks for the
The smile is giving way to a look of disappointment now as the scores come out from the seven judges. 9-3, 9-5s, a 9-4, for a total technically of 47.4. Thank God she wants to hide behind flowers. Oh, there's the smile back.
She's worked so hard this year, and this program doesn't represent what she's been doing all along. It's very odd that she would make this many mistakes. She's been training, working, and she's skating better than ever.
Total for Katya of 95.3. So Team Canada goes in front of Team Russia. 195.4 to 193.7. Katarina Witt and Christy Yamaguchi coming up when we return. Wiley are the strengths of this American team. The 1992 Olympic gold medalist will skate a solo tango, La Comparsita.
Team USA is sitting in fourth place, but this is the most ambitious program in this event.
Big double axel.
allowing these judges and this system, this program totally suits this event. She skates it clean. She does the lutz, the flip, the loop, and the toe. She'll get some huge marks. Triple lutz right here. A little short on the landing. She missed a few in the warm-up and have to think that she'd be tentative. Next jump coming up now is triple flip. It's probably her best triple. Nice triple flip. Again, the lutz and the flip are harder jumps than any one of the other ladies are doing tonight. Shows her strength, just hangs on to the landing and like nothing was wrong.
Teams do tangos. Christy's showing her versatility as a performer in this program.
Again, the way this program is constructed, balancing so many important technical elements, jumping, footwork, spins. It's exactly what these judges are looking for. Unfortunate mistake in the triple lutz shows her guts. Just going after every other jump in this program. Triple toe, beautiful. To go from missing the first triple to landing the rest says a lot about Christy Yamaguchi. She's gonna get some great marks for this performance.
Paul Wiley likes it. Carla Urbanski did as well, so did Rocky Marble. And so did the 92 Olympic gold medalist.
Unfortunate mistake in the triple lutz. She was pre-rotating with her upper body in practice a little bit early there. Look at the way down right there. She just didn't get her legs tight enough to complete the rotation. Quarter turn cheat, and you got to be forward or backwards if you're going to stand straight up. Triple flip, similar takeoff to lutz, except you turn backwards into it right here. Up, one, two, three, watch this foot on the landing. She gets right over that right side in the air. Great landing. And again, just to pick up from that triple lutz, do the triple flip and this triple loop, a little past it with the upper body, a little tilted, but look how strong she is to be able to hang on to that landing and give her a nice pose out of it saying, no problem.
One bobble at the beginning. Let's see how costly. 9-8 across the board, save a 9-9 from Judge 5, a total of 49 points.
Without the fall, you'd have to think those would be 9-9s and 10 straight across the board. It is the most ambitious program of all the technical programs in the women's competition.
And the artistic mark, high and low thrown out. Now you add the rest together and a total of 98 points for Christy Yamaguchi.
13.
The two-time Olympic gold medalist, Katarina Vint. The music is Don't Cry For Me, Argentina from Evita, and it is sung by Madonna.
Just coming off surgery on her ankle, and it's really limited what she can do technically. The most difficult jump in this performance will be a double axel, and that could hurt her because, again, this program is based on technical difficulty and diversity. Nice one foot landing, a lot of speed coming out. She really needed that.
As always, the crowd responds. Katarina Vitt with her teammates Rodka and Renee looking on. And we will return to the Bradley Center in Milwaukee, Wisconsin with Katarina Vitt's scores and those of Team Europe right after this.
Now the Northwestern Mutual
in this program, but watch this double axel. It gets straight up in the air, right up over the right side, lands on the right foot, 1 foot backwards, lots of speed, good presentation. Again, a clean performance, but without the difficulty of Christy Yamaguchi, Zosé Srinard.
It was a beautiful program. Choreography was lovely, and her presentation was very dramatic and powerful.
And the scores now, technically, for Katarina Witt. 9-7, 9-7, 9-5, which draws a roar of disapproval.
All they saw was a clean performance, but again, the difficulty is the technical program, and you've got to have the triples. She's working on them, but again, after the surgery, don't look cow. Don't look at the Marks cow. She's covering the cow's eyes.
And the second set of marks. She winds it up with 9-8. So the ladies' technical program captured by Christy Yamaguchi with a score of 98. Jose Chouinard was second. Katarina Vip. It was Team Canada that got out on the good foot as Jose Chouinard and the team of Brasseur and Eisler helped the Maple Leaf to the early lead. For Team USA's Christy Yamaguchi, the footing wasn't so secure. And Ekaterina Gordieva of Team Russia could only say, I'm sorry. Today, Kurt Browning looks to maintain the Canadian advantage as he'll face Paul Wiley and the world's best next. CBS Sports proudly presents the Northwestern Mutual Life World Team Championship. We are at the Bradley Center in Milwaukee, Wisconsin for our continuing coverage of this international team competition in professional figure skating. Four teams, and the USA is represented by the national champion pair of Urbanski and Marvel and Olympic medalist Christy Yamaguchi and Paul Wiley. Team Europe's pair are the world champions Kovajikova and Novotny, plus gold medalist Katarina Witt and bronze medalist Joseph Sobotchik. For Team Canada, and they are the leaders, Olympic medalist Isabelle Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler, national champion Jose Chouinard, and world champion Kurt Browning. And for Team Russia, the pair of Elena Betsky and Denis Petrov, Olympic gold medalist Katya Gordieva, and former world champion Alexander Fadeev. Today, we'll bring you the men's technical and the pairs artistic programs. And then next Saturday night in prime time, we'll decide the championship with the men's and ladies' artistic programs. Milwaukee, and on the ice for Team Canada, four-time world champion Kurt Browning, the music of Nat King Cole.
As a rule, man's a fool. When it's hot, he wants it cool. When it's cool, he wants it hot. Always wanting what is not. Are you disenchanted?
This program is subtitled Serenade de Sonia, dedicated to his wife,
can you find the
Sonia Rodriguez Browning.
You always dreaming of.
And if you want a pure example of someone who's made the transition from Olympic competitor to professional entertainer, ice skater, you're looking at it. He uses everything, facial expressions, body language, great choreography, and enormous jumps. Beautiful double axel.
I think one aspect of his skating that's really improved as a pro is his line. I think being married to Sonia, who's a dancer in the National Ballet of Canada, I think some of her technique has rubbed off on him because he has the poise and the carriage of a dancer.
just when you're ready to pitch it all, you're through looking, you're through caring, you're through dreaming. You've had it. And one day out of left field, there she is. At the airport in sunny Spain, I had 2 hours to catch a plane. I was lonely as I could be until a
triple sound cow
smiled at me. There was music, guitars, and in her eyes were a million stars. She was lovely beyond compare. And in that moment,
combination,
I
first jumping triple toe loop, the speed. Flow into another triple toe loop.
When did you first discover love? That wonderful moment when the world takes on a new and beautiful glow. Your senses whirl. Your heart stops, your pulse stops, and life begins. L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love.
Triple loop, most difficult jump in this program. Beautifully delivered.
Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me.
Another triple toe. Nicely landed. This footwork sequence is so difficult. Look at the toe work here.
To you, love, it's more than just a game for two.
And the big finish, a series of double axles. One, big one. Two. Really dizzy here for the third one. Three. Well, this is going to light up the scoreboard for sure. This program had everything these judges love. Beautiful performance from Kurt Browning.
Serenade to Sonia and his teammates, and they're on their feet in Milwaukee. Kurt Browning. And with Alexander Fadeev already having skated for Team Russia and Sabovchik for Team Europe, Browning should surpass their scores. This could be match play with Paul Wiley of Team USA. What a performance by Kurt Browning.
It's just so technically pure. Watch this triple sack, how it's up, it's in quick, and he's a little tilted outside, but tell you what, repetition is key. He knew exactly where he was, and he saved that jump beautifully. He's trained so hard, triple toe. Watch this, he lands it great. Nice speed, right into the second triple toe. Beautiful triple-triple combination there. Three double axles at the end of the program, there's one. Now the connecting steps between these three double axles is more turns counterclockwise, which only makes you more and more dizzy. So each one is kind of like tougher and tougher. Plus your legs are burning a little bit here. One more, come on, I know you're dizzy, but you can do it. In, out, no problem.
Technical mark. High and low get thrown out. Now the artistic mark.
Thank you.
questions? And having to listen to all Paul Wiley representing Team USA. The total of 99-2 for Kurt Browning. And Team Canada moves on top of both Team Europe and Team Russia. And now Paul Wiley, representing Team USA, Olympic silver medalist from 92. And Paul will skate the music from On the Waterfront.
This program, Skated Clean, is an absolute masterpiece. Paul is always known for his dynamics, his drama, his choreography, and this program suits him as well or better than any he's ever had. Difficult jumping passes off the top of the program. Opening jump, triple flip. Nicely landed. The most difficult jump in the program. He was really struggling in practice and warm up. Triple Lutz. Double. Against programs with Joseph Sabovchik's triple Lutz, triple flip, triple axel, Kurt Browning's triple choke combination, triple loop. He needs all the content he can get in this technical program to be competitive and to put USA back into it. Spin.
Paul Wiley, representing Team USA.
With only three triples in this program, he needed them all. The triple flip, well done. I think it's his best jump. You watch, he'll turn backwards here and he'll vault with his right foot. Straight up, straight in. Good air position. One, two, three. Nice landing going backwards. Great position. But the next jump was a triple Lutz. And again, watch his upper body. He pitches a little bit forward. He doesn't quite get all the way over that right foot. And you can see the tilt right there. There's no way he could do the third rotation and land it. He would have fallen hard and he pulled that in. And the triple toe at the end. He's very tired at this point in the program. And he just guts this one out. One, two, three, and out. But again, two triples landed against Kurt Browning and Joseph Sobotchick. He needs some good scores.
Now let's see how the judges assess Paul's performance. The technical mark. 9.8s, 2.97s, and judge 7.96, which will be thrown out. Total of 48.8. And the artistic mark. A total for Paul Wiley of 97.9. So among the men, Kurt Browning of Canada posts the top score of 99.2.
Team Canada looking awfully strong. Five artistic tens, a standing ovation. Incredible performance. You didn't notice?
No, I didn't. I was being kissed by Jose. I lost all track of where I was. But it's a special program, and I'm not feeling my best, and it was because of Jose. She was a great coach, and she really is gave me the good words.
Inspired by your teammates, you guys are halfway there. You've got a very comfortable lead. What do you do now? Do you play it safe?
Oh, no. that's not what got us here. It's, I think, the fourth year for the Northwestern Mutual, and Canada's never been anywhere but fourth and third. We're pretty excited, and we talked about it before the event, and Jose, I say, is really the team captain this year. She was calling in little team meetings, and with her French accent, it got us all pumped up.
And they're lucky you don't have to skate with your voice.
I'm very lucky.
Good luck. Thanks.
Thank you.